China's leaders are in the midst of a structural economic reform that could be as important as the changes that launched 30 years of extraordinary growth. This time around, the key is on structural reforms to try to move towards increased consumption and move away from the export industry. So when I was in China in December and I had a chance to talk with some of the leading reformers, they were emphasizing the work they're doing in terms of tax reform, for example, not only moving towards the value-added tax, but key shifts in terms of the expenditure-revenue relations between the center and the provinces. And then in areas such as financial markets, they're trying to build and integrate financial and capital markets, and importantly, move towards an open capital account. In the environment topic, it's obviously key to the welfare of the society, but it's also going to have implications for resource prices. Now, these are all coming together at a time where China is in the process of urbanization. So over the next few years, to move from about 54% urbanized today to about 70% in 2030. Vast expansion of the service sector. Well, simultaneously, you've got the United States going through an economic recovery. And one of the key aspects of the U.S. recovery has been the innovation, whether it's in energy or in software, big data, robotics, bioengineering industry. And intriguingly, the Chinese investment to the United States is now changing in pattern. It's predominantly private sector Chinese firms, not state-owned enterprises, both in terms of number of deals and in terms of the dollar volume of transactions. In general, what the Chinese investors have been looking for are technology, brand, know-how, management. They're trying to connect into the systems that they can also use in their domestic market. And over the past couple of years, the Chinese reformers have embraced the notion about trying to use a bilateral investment treaty to parallel and support their overall reform process. And so Goldman Sachs is hosting the U.S.-China CEO Bilateral Investment Dialogue, which will bring together CEOs from both countries, have some of the policy people involved, and to try to dig more deeply into what the experience is for private business executives in investing in both sides, but also trying to understand how the bilateral investment treaty might support their efforts, some of the issues that people are going to have to face going forward, and how to build support for this, but also recognize some of the challenges ahead and kind of what the next steps would be. So one thing to think about with these negotiations is that they not only can try to support China's reforms, they can not only try to build support in both countries for the economic relationships, but they're really part of the bigger Asia-Pacific economic picture. And so in that sense, trying to get CEOs together with policy people to understand the practical challenges of moving this ahead, I think would be extremely valuable.